Jax? Something wrong with the baby?
No, there's nothing wrong with the baby. Courtney's fine, too. It's just... I'm just worried that I'm going to lose yet another child.
I thought you and Courtney were getting along.
We've stopped attacking each other, but that's a far cry from celebrating the upcoming birth of our child together. No, Courtney's definitely shut me out. Of course, I made it worse. I overreacted when Helena threatened her.
Sorry, Jax.
I was just concerned for her and the baby's safety.
Of course. Well, that's understandable. But I kind of think Courtney knows what she's doing.
See, I just don't believe that they're in love. I mean, sure, they're attracted to each other, right? But soulmates? I mean, not like Nicholas and Emily. Or you and Lucky. I don't know. Maybe it's just wishful thinking on my part.
I just can't believe it was a year ago today that Nicholas and Emily got married.
Wait a second. Today is your anniversary?
Mm-hmm.
Really? Maybe that's our cue. Come here. Don't you ever wish for a do-over? You know, wish that you could go back and take the other fork in the road?
More times than I care to admit.
Okay, well, maybe this is our chance, you know? Give destiny a little push.
I don't like the way this sounds.
I just want to know, once and for all, if Nicholas and Emily are prepared to call it quits. Okay, and what better day to find that out than today, their wedding anniversary? I mean, if we could just get them together, you know, and somewhere, I don't know, we'll figure it out, but then we can see, you know, see what happens. Maybe true love will win.
And then Courtney would be free to be with you.
It would give us a chance. What do you say, Elizabeth? This is your chance to save two marriages.
I've never known two people to love each other like Nicholas and Emily. I mean, even at my wedding, when things were supposed to be over, they found a way to communicate without saying any words. And what's happening to him now, it breaks my heart.
So you agree with me?
I'm a romantic, Jax. And yes, I hold on to hope that they'll find their way back together, but without interference from you or me. Good, you're here.
You were looking for me.
Yeah, I knew you had a meeting and I wanted to catch you before you went in. Could you excuse us, please? Sure. I fired your guards, Jax. You know the ones you had camped outside my house? Actually, no, I sent them away. You get to fire them, or not. I don't care. But just keep them away from me, or I will file restraining orders against all of you.
Listen, I'm not the enemy here, okay? Helena Cassadine threatened you and the baby.
Well, it's over now, Jax, okay? Helena is taken care of. Nicholas had her committed to a Swiss Sam. Now you can officially stay out of my life and out of my business.
Now, you see, as long as you're pregnant with my child, you are my business.
See, there you go again, Jax, showing that you have absolutely no respect for boundaries.
Look, I won't apologize for wanting to protect you, okay? You and the baby. I want what's best for my family.
I am not your family, okay? Look, I know that you're not trying to be difficult, but obviously you're incapable of drawing the line, so I'll do it for you. Will you let me know if you're gonna make any decisions that impose on my life? Because I'll let you know if it's okay, all right? Reason, but you do tend to go a little overboard.
Oh yeah, she's still my wife and she's pregnant with my child. They were both threatened. Okay,
I don't think deception's the answer.
Didn't you tell me a while ago that you and Lucky would have never have gotten together if you hadn't gotten a push in the right direction from Nicholas and Emily? It's your chance to return the favor.
You can't make people do what they don't want to do.
No, I'm just saying, give them the opportunity, you know. They'll either take advantage of it or they won't. Hello.
Oh, great. I'm glad I caught you. Nicholas, I need to ask you a really big favor. Can Cameron and I come over to Windermere and grab some holly to make a wreath?
Of course. You don't even have to ask.
Except I'd really like you to be there.
And Cameron would love to see you.
Well, it just happens that I'm on my way home.
Great. I'll see you after work.
They're releasing me tomorrow.
Good.
Good, because I got the van out back. I was thinking of pulling your plugs and busting you out of here.
Hmm. You know, my little sister, she stopped by this afternoon. And she tells me that you're a funny guy to live with.
I'm a laugh riot. You know that. Is my little sweet pea up to something?
Like what?
I don't know. Something. Something secretive.
She's fine, Dad. But if you are that concerned, I mean, you should ask her yourself, because that's how parenting works.
You know, I'm so sick of people lecturing me about my poor parenting that
listen,
if you have nothing else to say, I'm going to leave.
How can you be so direct with me and so confused when it comes to Lulu?
I don't know. Maybe it's the XY chromosome thing. You've always been easier to talk to than Leslie Liu. And now I find she comes with a heaping helping of pure Spencer DNA.
Okay. Is that a bad thing?
I don't know. Maybe she's going to turn out more devious, more larcenous than I would have ever given her credit for being.
Well, coming back to work.
Oh, God, I am so proud of you for not giving up med school. And not that it's my place to say, but you would have been making a huge mistake.
You're not the only one who thought so. A whole bunch of people weighed in on my so-called career. So I'm going to look at it as a fresh start for me.
Good.
So are you off duty soon?
Yeah, but unfortunately, not soon enough.
Can I ask you a favor? What's up? Cameron and I went to Windermere earlier to gather some holly for a wreath, and we left his little lion in the garden. You know, his favorite stuffed animal that he sleeps with every night, and I want to go get it, but I don't think I'm going to get off here on time, and I want to get home so I can decorate the house for Lucky.
Do you think you want me to go over to Windermere and get it for him?
Cameron would love you forever. Not that he won anyway, but I will owe you big time.
No, of course I'll get it for him. I can go over there this evening.